tracking milestones of an incredible journey spanning 30 years, Rehman Music Sheets. Rehman was becoming a rage in South India. With each film, he was redefining film music in Tamil cinema. Ram Gopal Verma had decided that Rehman will compose music for Rangeela. This was going to be Rehman's first ever original film score for a Hindi film. But producers of Rangeela hadn't even heard of Rehman. This episode with Ram Gopal Verma continues the story of Rangeela. How he got Rehman? Well, in a barter.
When you started working on Rangeela, you really had to negotiate with your producers also to go for Rehman and not for other names.
Yeah. See, at the time, I was actually making two films in Hindi. One is called Nayak with Sanjay Dutt. And Sanjay Dutt got arrested halfway through, which is the reason it got shelved. Now, Anu Malik was doing the music. So my producers were more interested in that project because Sanjay Dutt was a bigger star than Amir at that time. And of course, Anu Malik was the biggest music director at that time. So they were, Jammu Sugan said, who's Rehman? This one is done Roja and all that, you know. They somewhere felt, okay, Nayak is a big picture. Ramu is making this for Just Like That, whatever. So if we say no to this, he might not do that. So it is on some kind of a mind frame like that. Rehman I got in barter, you know, because if I can take Anu Malik for Sanjay Dutt's film, then we are okay with Rehman for Rangeela. And little did anybody know that Rangeela will become the biggest,
A decade later, Nayak was finally made as Sarkar. Rangeela, a major box office hit, won 7 Filmfare Awards, including Special Jury Award for Asha Bhosle and trophy for the best music to A.R. Rehman.
The contribution of Rehman to me was of a far more greater magnitude because for me, it opened up my mind to music in a way I've never really thought about it. Because when I was making Rangeela, the kind of a new sounds and the purity in melody, it somehow forces a director, a filmmaker to expand his horizons in how he can picturize it, you know. What Rehman's music does is, you have no choice but to think differently, right from the choreographer to the director to all concerned, even the rendering of the actor becomes different because he has to follow the track somewhere. I remember Amir telling me, the first time I am hearing sometimes song not coming on beat, you know, I didn't know what that was precisely at that time. But the point is, I am reacting to the sound. Amir is more closely into the technicalities of music also, you know. And to use a Rehman kind of voice on Amir Khan at that time for a Mangta Hai Kya song was very, very path-breaking because Amir was feeling that people might laugh, you know, because he's so used to hear Udit Narayan. Now, Rehman completely destroyed the aspect of one conventional singer like S.P. Balu or Chitra singing. You will just get anyone because anyone makes a song sound different. So the unconventional approach somewhere forces, not only in the music per se, even the way the directors think about song picturation, choreography, sets, how to challenge each other to make it. So I think that's what I meant by it expands your horizons.
Have you been privy to that particular scenario when he is actually composing or you only hear the tracks that are sent to you?
There were times when me and Rehman traveled to Goa for composing. I spent around 5 days at Taj Village Hotel there. And so in the process. But of course, Rehman works alone. When a director or anybody creates a piece, he looks for appreciation. He looks for an enthusiastic reaction. He just doesn't do that. And first time when my flat, he composed the Yaire song of Rangeela. he was doing it with his headphones, and he called me, Ram, I made something, just listen to it. And I also listened to it on the headphones. And when I told him it's fantastic, he said, are you sure? He said, you know, because he's all the time, it's not about being doubtful. He just wants to be sure, are you sure the tune is working? At the time of creation, is so much into it, but the excitement doesn't show in what he's looking. He's not dying for a compliment. He's not dying for an enthusiastic response from you, which I think is, I wouldn't say it is good or bad. I think it's very unique, because all artists are dying for that kind of an obvious response of people raving about their work, you know. So I think that quality is something, again, which I've seen only in Rahman. Rahman is the only guy I met in my life who doesn't have creative arrogance. He would never ever defend something he made. He would never ever say, this is good, you should take it, you know. He doesn't do that. I mean, if you for some reason think it's not good, he would want to make another tune, but he will never defend or explain it, which is even more fascinating, you know. The uniqueness about Rahman and the way he gets work out of both singers and musicians, I would say, he would never command them. All the typical music directors I've seen work with them, they'll always order a musician. There's a C note, this, what are you doing, this and that. I've seen him interacting with them in a way as if the song belongs to them. Do you think this is right? Do you think you can, I think you should play something like this. So him sounding unclear about what he wants, deliberately, I would think, forces the musician to feel for himself and think, rather than following an order. Following an order becomes mechanical. But what Rahman does is, he has something in his mind, not to crystal clearly tell, and to provoke that thought, provoke that feeling into the musician or the singer, the way they should render it, and to treat them as stars. They are making a song. He makes them feel that the song belongs to all of us, actually more to you than me. He might not say it in so many words, but that's a feeling. Because of that reason, no musician or no singer sound in any other music director the way they sound with Rahman.
The general belief about Rahman's music is that the singers, the voice, even to some extent the lyrics, are just one of the embellishments. It's the total package that works. How do you...
I won't say that. You see, the point is, eventually a song works because of the way it makes you feel. You know, fair enough. Most people, I don't think, listen to lyrics. But I think what the lyric does is, the meaning of the lyric, it gives the singer a certain aspect to render it, which translates into an emotion. You know, then how that is packaged and what comes underneath that or above that or in between that is what which gives it a body, fleshing out for a want of a better word. So I think the whole thing becomes seamless after some time, and where you don't know where something ended and where something began. See, Rahman, I really think, is like a sculptor. A funny example, someone told me once, it's very easy to be a sculptor. If you want to sculpt a dog, a rock into a shape of a dog, you should just take that piece of rock and sculpt away whatever doesn't look like a dog. You know, it's a very funny example. But in the context of Rahman, in the reverse, to make something as a first thought, and then after everyone liking it, then he revisits after maybe a week or 10 days later, and he listens to the fresh mind, it's almost as if he hasn't done it, someone else has done it. And then some other new idea comes, because the creation eventually is a constant process of evolution. You know? And so most people, including me, I'm not only talking about music directors here, we, after the first thought, we execute it and we already think that we created a masterpiece till the audience tells us otherwise, at a much later stage. We just kind of tend to forget it. But till the time reaches the final mix stage and it is delivered, he will still be looking at it as in a process of evolution. It is still being made. It's never been made completely. You know, that kind of a dedication, that kind of a passion towards a finished product, towards a product is something very, very uncommon, I think, you know.
In our next episode, Rehman's process and aesthetics of making music through the eyes of Ram Gopal Verma. Stay with us. Rehman Music Sheets will continue to track his incredible journey to superstardom, connecting you with his creative partners, also engaging with musicians he inspired. If you have reinterpreted or recreated Rehman's music, share your videos. If selected, you will get featured on Rehman Music Sheets. To submit your videos, log on to our website o2-india.com.